Good morning, this Vision family. Good morning to everyone who's joining us online this morning. Thank you so much for joining us. Please wake up those who are still not awake and tell them that His Vision Church is live. And please make sure to share this stream so that it can reach as many people as possible. This is the good way to start a day. Amen.
Amen.
Yesterday we had tremendous time in our online services and we had a powerful prayer for our nation in the evening. Amen. We stood firm on the word of God. We agreed on certain principles as children of God.
Yeah.
We are so blessed to have that prayer. We are so thankful to our leaders for all that they are doing, for being able to lead us even in this time without any doubt, without wavering, standing firm, fixing their eyes on Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
We give you praise. And this morning, I'm with my brother, Mornay.
Hi, Nyapi.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Awesome. Again, thank you guys for streaming in this morning with us. I was making a joke with my Lumanilo on my way. I was telling him, no, this morning he must just, I'll do video call if you put me like this. It's cold this morning. But I just want to greet a couple of people that's live with us on Facebook. And Malume Brian, I see you are here with us this morning. Welcome to you. We've got Mrs. Lisa De Bruyn here. Morning, ma'am. Welcome to you. We've got Malume Andile, who is here with me. Morning again, Malume. We have Mrs. Michelle Janssen from Rensburg here this morning. Good morning. Welcome. Thank you for streaming in. And Brother Marius all the way. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Brother Marius. And then let me just check here. We've got Tabo Lezenyane. Morning. Thank you. And our pastor, Pastor Fraksha. Thank you awesome. So much for streaming thank in you, this morning. And again, Pastor Drikas, thank you so much for streaming pastor in D. this morning. We've got Elmarie van Asjegen Smith here with us. Good morning. Corey Smith, good morning. We've got Donovan van Amerwe. Good morning to you guys. I hope you are blessed. We've got Nicoline Janssen van Rensburg. Good morning to you. And then we also have Mrs. Lezenyane here this morning. Good morning to you as well, ma'am. We've got Dwayne Whitboy. Good morning to you. Pastor Angel, thank you for joining this morning. Good morning. Anna Elizabeth Stickling, good morning. Thank you for joining. Let me just see here. We've got Esther Janssen van Rensburg. Good morning. Thank you again for joining. And then that is so far what I can see here for the people who have joined us. As you keep on joining, guys, as you know, this morning we want to continue in prayer for those who have prayer requests. Please, as the morning continues, just list your prayer requests today, and we would love to pray with you this morning over that is concerning in your heart. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. As we are going to start to pray, please become aware of the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
If you are not too busy, please take time to really engage, to join in, to pray with us, to stand together with us, to trust with us. Hallelujah. Yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise, Lord. We give you honor. We glorify you, Lord Jesus. As we come before you this morning, Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for this day, Lord, saying this is the day that you have made, Lord. Father, we shall rejoice and be glad in this day, O Lord. We start this day, Lord, with thanksgiving in our hearts, Lord Jesus. We start this day, Lord Jesus, with joy, Lord, with praise, Lord, with thanksgiving, Lord. We come before you, Lord Jesus Christ, knowing that, O Father, there is no other better way than starting the day by dedicating it unto you, Lord Jesus, by asking you, Lord, to go ahead of us, Lord, as we go back to school, O Lord, as we go back to our workplaces, in the almighty name of Jesus, that Father, you will sanctify the place, Lord, you will make everything safe, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, you go ahead of us, Lord, you make way where there seems to be no way, O Holy Spirit, in the almighty name of Jesus, Father, we stand in the gap, Lord, for all the learners, Lord, and the teachers that are going back to work after a long time, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus, Lord, we speak protection over them, Lord, that, O Lord, you will come, O Lord Jesus, in person, Lord, in those places, Lord Jesus, of work, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for giving them strength, for giving them new hope, Lord, for giving them the knowledge of who you are, that, Lord, they will go back with no fear in their hearts, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. We glorify you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for this land of ours, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
We thank you for our leaders, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that we are able to stand firm together as the people of the land, Lord, and agree, Lord, that, Father, we put you ahead, Lord, that there is nothing, O Lord, that can ever stop us, Lord, from going forth, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
we glorify
Lord.
You, Lord Jesus. Therefore, Lord, we say, Lord Jesus, may the meditations of our hearts, Lord, the utterances of our mouths, Lord, be acceptable unto you, Lord Jesus.
Lord.
In the name of Jesus, we glorify you, Lord. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for who you are. We thank you, Lord, for accepting us by your blood, Lord. We thank you, Father, Lord, for grabbing us, O Lord, from the power of the enemy, Lord Jesus, and bring us over to the kingdom of the light, Lord. In the almighty name of Jesus, for sanctifying us by your blood, O
Lord.
For bringing us forth, O Lord Jesus. Now, Lord, we come with no fear, Lord. We approach the throne of grace, O Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
We glorify you, Lord Jesus. We are here today because of your faithfulness to the cross, Lord. Had it not been for your faithfulness, O Lord, we wouldn't be here to even testify of your goodness, Lord. We wouldn't be here, O Lord, to say that you are God. You are still the same God who you have been, Lord. In the almighty name of Jesus, your steadfast love, O Lord, that, O Lord Jesus, shows itself every day, Lord. Your mercies that have new new every morning in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We know, oh Lord, that Jesus, difficult times may come in the night, Lord, but joy comes in the morning, Lord.
Yes,
joy of
Lord.
Saying thank you, Lord, for protecting us, Lord. Joy of saying, Lord, we went to sleep and we woke up, oh Lord, still safe, oh Lord, in the almighty
yes.
name of Jesus.
Yes,
to say, Father,
Jesus,
we don't
yes.
take this for granted. We know that, Father, many people could not even wake up, Lord. It was by your grace, Lord. It was by your mercy, oh Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
we glorify you, therefore, Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. You are worthy to be praised, Lord Jesus. You are worthy, Lord. There is no other God that we run to, Lord. There is no other refuge, oh Holy Spirit, in the almighty name of Jesus. There is no other hiding place, Lord, that we can run to, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. We hide under your wings, oh Lord. We need your protection like never before, oh Lord. We need you, Lord Jesus. We need your presence, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. Reawaken our spirit unto your truth, oh Lord. Reawaken us, oh Lord, unto who you are, Lord. That, oh Father, Lord, we shall continue to trust. We shall not waver, Lord. We shall not be double-minded, Lord. In the almighty name of Jesus, we glorify you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' almighty name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus.
Wow, it was really powerful.
Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
We just, in this presence, just be mindful of God's presence in this moment. Try not to allow distractions to come against anything this morning.
Yes, Father.
The Lord wants to impart something in our hearts this morning. Amen.
Yes, Jesus.
To impart it into our hearts that when you go out into this world this day, when you go out through this week, that the things of the world will not come against your heart. Even the word declares that a double-minded man cannot receive. The word says that do not be unstable in all your ways, wavering between your faith and wavering between what you hear in the world.
Yes, Lord.
Now, the world's news is like sanitizer. It was never meant to go inside. It was always just supposed to be around you. Even if it comes in contact with you, it was supposed to just come in contact and dry off. It was never supposed to go inside and contaminate what is inside. Faith is that what is inside. Faith is that what is inside that should not ever be contaminated by those things of the world. And Yonas Malume Andili just prayed now. He said that those who go to the Lord, you know, his name is a strong tower. And you know, Pastor Francois shared a beautiful message over this weekend where, you know, refocusing your faith. Refocusing your faith. I know that many times we make mistakes and we feel like we have fallen short, or we feel like we've deviated from the course that God has set out for us. We feel like we have not, you know, lived up to that mark, not made the mark. And God does not look at us in that sense. If it was like that, I was going to have trouble. And you know, it's not like that. God is there. He never called us according to our capability, but He called us according to our availability. How we avail our heart onto the hearkening of His Spirit. You know, when Jesus stood there, and this is something that very powerful, it had a very different revelation for me. Jesus stood there and He already had a plan in mind, right? When He looked at all the it was 5,000 men He looked at after preaching to them. The disciples said that they must be dispersed so that they might go and get food, and they might go get and get nourishment for their families. And the Bible speaks only about the men. God knows how many women and children there were. Men, probably 20,000 or even more, you know? And if you look at it like this, Jesus didn't have a whole buffet table waiting for them to feast from.
Yes.
But yet, the plan that He had already made and established in His heart was to provide for them.
Yes.
While the provision was not in sight.
Hallelujah.
He knew. He knew that He knew, because his faith was, it wasn't going to get challenged.
Amen.
His faith was not going to get challenged. He wasn't going to allow that what He saw around Him, you know, His fleshly eyes, to dictate to Him the plan that God wants to make. He said, now I will make the plan of my Father. I will let the dream of my Father manifest through me, whether it looks like it's possible or not. And imagine now. Now he's waiting upon the Lord for provision. He comes to a boy comes to him with two fishes and a few loaves of bread. That's it. That's the provision. He did not complain. He did not get unbelief in his heart. He did not become worrisome or fearful. If I was in his position, I would have been very fearsome. They were going to eat something. I don't know where they would have found it. We would have been plucking grass and made salad. So what did Jesus do? With an attitude of gratitude, he refocused his sight. He looked up. The word, if you go look at it in the original translation, when it said, and he looked up and gave thanks, he says he refocused his sight. He refocused. Refocused from what? Refocused from what he saw around him. Refocused from what he saw around him. The plans according to the flesh. The provision according to the flesh. The dreams according to the flesh. And he refocused according to the plan of God. The dream of God for that situation that he wants to manifest in that place right there and then. The provision that God wants to provide in that place there and then. You see, and you can't be double-hearted in your heart because then you can't receive. So he needed to stand there in full faith, knowing that God will provide no matter what. No matter what. He knew God is not a God that will turn back on his word. He will never leave you nor forsake. He will always be there for you. He's Jehovah Jireh. And he looked up, he recovered his sight, and he divided the food. And it didn't run out. In fact, they had baskets, 12 baskets. 12 baskets. 12 baskets symbolize the 12 disciples who spread the food. Meaningly that there was more than enough for those who came. And each and every servant, there was even those who handled the blessing. Not even those who the blessing was for. Your life, that what God imparts into your heart, the blessing might be for those around you, but there's no way that you can distribute the blessings from your heart, the table of your heart, without that blessing getting onto you or yourself as well, or without that blessing affecting you. It is impossible. If it was, it was even enough for them, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Brother Mornay. I see we've got a prayer request here, and we're going to pray. It is from Kosi Acheta. He says, morning pastors, pray for protection for my family as they are going back to Limpopo today. Amen. This is the brother that I know from outside. He also had COVID and God healed him. He is healed. He is free of COVID. Amen. So we're going to pray. Amen. We're going to pray for all people. We're going to pray for protection over people. But as Mornay has spoken about looking up, about fixing our eyes to Jesus. We know Pastor prayed so wonderful, shared so wonderful yesterday, this word of fixing our eyes to Jesus. Mornay has just spoken now about the voices, about what surrounds us, about giving attention to what surrounds us. Amen. You know what surrounds us impacts us. It forms us in a way, one way or the other. Amen. That is why, therefore, as the children of God, we choose to shut the doors.
Yes.
To shut out all the things that are not from God.
Yes.
And fix our eyes on Jesus.
Yes.
But this morning, as we are fixing our eyes on Jesus, Jesus looked up to his Father. He had a relationship, intimate relationship with the Father. He came to represent the Father. He came to reveal the Father. There is not a thing that he did on his own. He always spoke of my Father, the one who sent me.
Yes.
Amen. Now, as children of God, in this time of difficulty, how do we fix our eyes on Jesus? Before we do even that, do we know Jesus? Jesus once asked this question from his disciples in Matthew 16. And ask them, who do people say I am? And they said, well, John the Baptist, amen, and some of the prophets, and others say you are Elijah. Then he said, who do you say am I? Amen. I want to use that as our point of departure this morning, that as we fix our eyes on Jesus, who is Jesus to you?
Yes.
How do we see Jesus? Because our way of seeing will determine our way of moving, our way of following, our way of trusting.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You know, the Israelites, they saw Jesus as the bread of life. They saw him as the rock that gave them water. They saw him as the way maker who made way. They saw him as the one who produced water in the place of drought. Hallelujah. They saw him as that rock of foundation who do you say Christ Jesus is unto you?
Mm.
Amen. Peter said, you are Messiah, you are the Christ, hallelujah. And Jesus said, that revelation is not from the human perspective. My Father has given that to you, Peter.
Yeah.
And on this rock, I will build my church, hallelujah. Now, as people, we need to understand who Jesus is unto us. As we fix our eyes, we need to know that Jesus is our banner.
Yes.
Jesus is the one that we lift up.
Yeah,
Jesus is Jehovah Nissi. Jesus is our battle stander. He is Jehovah Shabbat.
Yes.
Jesus is our deliverer.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is the one who changes things like this in an instant.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus is the one we build on, is our foundation. The Bible says there is no other foundation.
Mm.
Jesus is our advocate who fights for us, who defends us. Even when we become inaccurate, he is there to redeem us all over again.
Yes.
He is there to fight for us. He is there to say, not over my child. You have no authority over this child. I've chosen him. I've set him apart.
Yeah,
this is my child. Hallelujah. We know that we are no longer slaves to fear.
Mm.
We know that now we are the inheritors of the promise. We are the heirs of this promise. Hallelujah.
Mm.
Therefore, we stand on the promises of God in the midst of this darkness. We put on our light, for we are the light. We are the salt to the earth. Amen.
Amen.
Who Jesus is unto you. Who Jesus is unto you. God once said to Moses, when Moses said, Lord, you are sending me out there to Pharaoh, and what am I going to say?
Yeah.
Who sent me?
Yes.
Who will I say has sent me? And he said, when you get there, Moses, tell him that I am who I am has sent me.
Yes.
I am who I am has sent me.
Yeah.
In isiXhosa we say, ndinguye endinguye. Ndinguye endinguye. I am who I am has sent me. Hallelujah. This morning, who is Jesus to you?
Mm.
Who is Jesus to you? Because whomever you see Jesus as, is your reality of who Jesus is.
Mm.
Is your point of departure, is your point of standing firm, is how you're gonna follow him, is how you're gonna not be moved, is how you will even be able to shut out all the other voices and focus your eyes on him, because he's our high priest who
was
ordained in the order of Melchizedek. Though he had no prior lineage to being a priest, though he did not belong to the Levites, but he is the priest forever. All the other priests, they discontinued because they died from time to time, but he, Jesus, is the priest who lives forever, because he became the sacrifice. The other priests, they gave sacrifice for their sins and for the people, but Jesus became that living sacrifice. Therefore, child of God, we need to dig deep, into knowing the completed work of the cross.
Yes.
The completed work of the cross, what the cross means for us as children of God, what Jesus did for us at the cross. Jesus did the complete work.
Amen.
We need to rest in that work. We need to fix our eyes on Jesus. We need to know that Jesus is our provider. When we are in need of provision, we fix our eyes on him. We say, God, if you don't come through, we know, Lord, there is no one else. Therefore, we rely on you, Lord Jesus. We call upon your name,
Lord,
because we know you will never leave us. You will never forsake us, Lord. You will never let us be attacked by the enemy. That's why, therefore, we say, had it not been for Jesus, the enemy would have come and devoured us. But Jesus is there for us. Jesus is fighting our battles. In the almighty name of Jesus, Father, we come against the spirit of fear, Lord.
Yes,
we come against the spirit of timidity. We come, O Holy Spirit, against the spirit of Lord Jesus, of thinking that you have forsaken us, Lord. We know that, Lord, your mercies are new each and every day, Lord. You are there to protect us, Lord. You are there to empower us, Lord. We know, Father, that your vision is bigger than our own vision, Lord. Therefore, Lord, we renew our heart, we renew our strength, Lord. We change our seeing, our way of seeing, oh Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus, we pray for the enlightenment of eyes, Lord, that we will see you, Lord, as you see us, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. We know that we are inheritors of the promise. Therefore, Lord Jesus, we will not be shaken, Lord. We will not be moved, oh Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus, as we come, Lord, to pray, Lord, for protection for all those who are traveling in between the provinces, Lord, going back and forth, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, for all those who are sick, Lord, for all those who are weak, Lord, all those who are in hospitals, in the almighty name of Jesus, that, Lord, you will give them new strength, Lord, you will give them new eyes, Lord, you will give them new ability, Lord, to look up to you, Lord Jesus, in the almighty name of Jesus. Like Father, when you, Lord, you healed the man who was born blind, Lord, you said, Father, you said, open up. Therefore, Lord, we pray that we'll open up our ears and eyes, Lord, we'll allow, Father, Lord Jesus, new vision to come in our eyes, Lord. We'll allow, Father, Lord Jesus, all our paths that take information in, Lord, to take the information from you, Lord, to take the knowledge from you, in the almighty name of Jesus. Father, we come, Lord, against every image that raises itself, Lord, against the image of God, in the almighty name of Jesus. We pull down all the thrones, Lord. We pull them down in the almighty name of Jesus, with our weapons of spiritual weapons, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. You are faithful, my Lord. We give you praise, Lord. We honor you, Lord Jesus. We fix our eyes upon you, Lord. We know, Father, Lord Jesus Christ, you are our hiding place, Lord. We know, Father, that our help will come only from you, Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. Therefore, Lord, we say, Lord, we trust unto you, Lord. Let us never be ashamed, O Lord. We give you praise, Lord. We glorify you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for being the mighty God that you are, Lord. Thank you for being the immovable God that you are, Lord. Therefore, Lord, you give us power, Lord, both to will, O Lord Jesus, and to do your word, Lord. We don't do this word out of obligation, Lord. Jesus. We don't do this because, O Lord, we are obligated, but because we love you, Lord. Jesus, in the name of the Lord, you said, Father, the purpose of the commandment is love from a pure heart, in the almighty name of Jesus, a clear conscience and sincere faith, O Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise, honor you, we glorify you. Are worthy, Lord. You are worthy to be praised. Only you, Lord, are worthy of all praise, Lord. Only you, Lord, are worthy of all glory, Lord. There is no one like you, in Jesus almighty name. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
And Father, this morning we just want to come before you, Lord. We want to lay Christine de Beer in front of you, Father. We lay her at your feet, Lord. Lord, this morning we pray for your mighty hand of protection over her life, Father. Lord, we pray that this morning you will be the wall of fire around her, Lord, so that no arrow of the enemy will come near her. Lord, Father, we know that the weapon might be formed, but it will not prosper. And this morning, Father, we declare and decree each and every one of your promises over her life, Lord. Lord, let everything in her life come in line with your promises, Lord. Let nothing be out of place, Father. Lord, this morning we throw chains on everything that is not supposed to be there, Lord. We throw chains. Father, Lord, we pray for your supernatural health in her life, Lord, that no enemy will bring a virus against her, nor no word spoken against her will prosper, Father. But this morning we pray, Lord, as each and every attack comes, Father, it will flee, Lord, in seven difference. We thank you, Lord, this morning, that you will be the fire in and upon her life, Lord. And as you split the sea for Moses, you will do for her, Lord, and you will be behind her with your glory, Father. And as your mighty power will break out before her, Lord, to prepare a path. Therefore, this morning, Lord, I know that you will, Lord, you will break every boulder in front of her, Lord, with your hand of protection over her, Lord. And we pray for a supernatural peace that transcends all understanding, Lord. Lord, that there will not be any fear, Lord. But we pray that the scripture of Timothy, Lord, that says that perfect love will push away all fear. This morning, this is where we declare perfect love in Christine's life, Lord. Yes, Lord, we just declare your perfect love, a soothing comfort, Father, in the name of Jesus.
In the almighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. We give you praise, Lord. We know that Jesus is our high priest. Jesus is our advocate. Jesus fights our battles. Jesus has always been the same God that he has always been. Hallelujah.
Yes.
But we need to change our way of seeing. Jesus said that he is the way, he is the life. Hallelujah. If we live in Jesus, We have the fullness of who God is. We have the fullness revelation of who God is. If we use Jesus as the way of doing things, hallelujah. We're going to pray right now for all the businesses, amen. We're going to pray for our people. We know that God has given our people the businesses to prosper. We know that God is in it. Child of God, I want to promise you that God is not sleeping on the job.
Yes.
God never sleeps nor slumbers.
Yes.
God is always in control. God is always working behind the scenes. Even if we don't see it, we don't see it, but God is working. Even if we feel it or we don't feel it, but God is working.
Yes.
Because God is not dependent on what we do. God is not dependent on our action. That is why God is able to make the sun shine both on the righteous and unrighteous, because God does not look at what we do, but he looks at our heart. He searches the heart. Make sure that you do things for the right purpose. Make sure that you do things for pure love. Make sure you do things from a sincere faith. Make sure you do things for a clear conscience. In
yes.
the almighty name of Jesus, Jesus still sits in the throne. Even in this time, he sits on that throne. He is standing right in the right hand of the Father, interceding for you and I. Praying for things that we don't even know. Praying for the new vision, that we will be renewed in our vision, renewed
yes.
in our strength. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Jesus Christ said to Peter and the disciples that the devil has asked for you to sift you, but I have prayed for you, especially you, Peter.
Mm.
I have prayed for you that you should not lose your faith, that you should not lose your faith. The most thing that we need not to lose right now is faith. We need to trust Jesus more than we ever did. We need to stand firm on the word of God more than we ever did. Jesus Christ has decided to put his word above his own name, because there is nothing better than the word of God. The word of God is steadfast. It's never changing. It's there. It's always been there. It always yes. shall be there. Everything can pass away. All the earth can pass away. The heavens can pass away, but the word of God will remain.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Out of all three, love will remain.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. We know that Jesus is faithful.
Yes.
Jesus does not change. Jesus is not like us men, that he shall lie.
Yes.
Every promise that he has made is true.
Mm.
When Jesus said, I have called you by name before you were even born, it is true. If God says it, that settles it. There is no other second opinion unto it. There is no doubting in unto it. There is no wavering. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Because every promise that God gives us is a yes and amen.
Amen.
Every
yeah,
promise
yeah, yeah.
that he gives is true. In the almighty name of Jesus, Father, we pray that, oh Lord,
thank
we
you,
will
Jesus.
Fix our eyes on you, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Are our provider, Lord. You are the King of Kings, Lord.
Yes,
you are the
Lord.
One, Lord, who turns something in nothing into something, Lord. You are the one, Lord, who has the power to multiply, oh Holy Spirit, even the little that we have, Lord. Father, I pray that you give us new strength, you give us faith, Lord. As Pastor Angel has prayed last night and said, God, increase our faith.
Yes,
God,
Lord.
Increase our faith. This is the time to believe God more than before.
Yes.
This is the time to rely unto him more than we can
Please
ever
so
do. In the almighty name of Jesus, I pray for each and every individual,
yes,
every
Jesus.
Believer to stand firm on his conviction, to stand firm on his faith, to ask God to renew your faith, because
yes.
this is not something that we can do on our own.
Yes,
for the disciples to ask Jesus in that instance, he was preaching to them about forgiveness,
yes.
and they realized that this is so difficult, they cannot do it on their own. They realized that they needed him. They
yes,
realized
Jesus.
That they needed to believe. If we do not believe, we cannot even have that forgiveness.
Yes,
Father,
Jesus.
We thank you, Lord Jesus, for speaking against you. We pray that, oh Lord, you forgive us, oh Lord, that, oh Lord, we doubt you, Lord. From time to time, Lord, we look from other sources,
yes,
but
Jesus.
Lord, we know that you are the source of all things.
Yes,
everything
Jesus.
Flows from you. The Bible says that everything was created through your Son, for your Son, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. And He holds everything together in the almighty name of Jesus. Before all things were created, your Son was in the almighty name of Jesus. Therefore, Lord, we know everything that we have was created by your word, Lord, was created for your purpose, Lord, was created for revealing your glory, was created to reveal you, Lord, was created to reveal who you are. In the almighty name of Jesus, we give you praise, Lord, that we shall glorify you, Lord, through our businesses, Lord, through our finances, Lord, in our families, in the almighty name of Jesus. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 31 says, whatever we do, whether we eat or we drink, we do it unto the glory of God. Child of God, I want you to glorify God with your life. I want you to glorify God with everything that you do. I want you to put the glory of God ahead of it. It's not about whether I'm doing right or wrong. It's about whether God receives glory out of what I do, in the almighty name of Jesus. Father, renew the people's faith, O Lord, that, O Lord, we look more unto you, Lord, that, Father, we run unto you, Lord, that, Father, we hide under your wings, Lord, that, Father, we hide into you, Lord Jesus, that even when the enemy is looking for us, Lord, they will not find you, will not find us, Lord, because we are hidden on the inside of you, in the almighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father, come, O Holy Spirit, and strengthen us, O Lord. Oh, come, O Lord, and make us, O Father, Lord, what you want us to be, O Lord, in the almighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray that, Lord, in that faith we shall be able to understand your purpose, Lord, to understand that you are in charge, O Lord, to understand that, O Lord, you are the author and the finisher of our faith.
Yes, Lord.
In the almighty name of Jesus, you be revealed, Lord, in our lives. You be revealed, Lord, in everything that we do, in the almighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lord.
Amen. Amen. Yes, Lord. This is awesome. It is very, very important that we stay in prayer in this time. You know, we are having the services at night at 5 when we pray for our nation, and we don't pray for our nation because we just skimmed, we have nothing better to do. We know we pray because the word declares, watch and pray, watch and pray. That is it's a proactive movement of God. It's a proactive way to make sure that in prayer we stay ahead of it. In prayer we can oversee. In prayer we can speak that what we need to see in the spiritual. We can pray it, and God knows that the word that we speak, that will become, if we declare it, He will manifest it. He will establish it. We pray over things. We pray in our services. We pray over people's life, over our nation. We pray for wisdom in our president. We pray for wisdom in those who are in control of the schools and the education system. We pray for the next generation to come. We continue to stay in prayer. And in this time, it is important for us as Christians to stay in prayer. A man of God once said that a Christian can see more from his knees than he can see from his feet. It's important that you stay in prayer throughout this time. It is only through prayer, and the oracles of God through us speaking. I mean, a parent speaking over their child, that what God says. The Bible says that we will not live by word alone, but from every word that proceedeth. That word will proceed from in within God and the Holy Spirit within you, through your mouth, into the lives of the people around you. If we want to see change in South Africa, we have to start declaring it. Therefore, this morning I want to motivate you. Please be mindful of what you say. Be mindful of what you speak. Be mindful in your workplace of the lingo. How you speak with those around you. What you say. Are you going to speak with the flow of the world? Are you going to stick with that negativity? Sometimes people can be very negative around us, and we have a decision to decide what we will tolerate around us. Because what you tolerate, you bless. Do not tolerate the words of the world and the mentality. Rather be the light unto them. In fact, even the Bible declares that around you there might be dense darkness, in the book of Isaiah 60. It says around you there might even be dense darkness. It never was ignorant towards the fact that we will be in certain places where there will be certain things present. But it said, but upon you the light will shine. Be the light to the people around you. Be the light to the people around you. Be the word of wisdom around. Be that that motivation through Christ in their lives. You know, some of the people in the workplace and then at school, for those who are watching and going to school now, you will be the only Bible some people get to read.
Yes.
Your life will be the only Bible.
Yes.
You will be the only representation of Jesus that they will ever see. Go out there and do and speak the word of God. It says, let the meditations not let it not depart from your mouth. Let it be on your mouth. When they come to you, they must look for godly insight in your life. They must be attracted to you for godly insight upon your life and the wisdom upon your life. And you know what? As that happens, God will give you more and more authority. And as your authority increases, the word declares that your tent will be uplifted and spread out even further.
Amen.
And your influence of God's love in their hearts, might it be mighty and great. And I think that's about it, Manume and Dile. I think if you
Amen.
Want to say something.
Hallelujah. One last thing that I want to say. The church is the only vehicle through which God is working.
Yes.
Therefore, we need to really awaken the church. I know the churches are not gathering now. I think we're allowed for 100 people, 50 people now.
50 people, yeah.
After last night's presidential speech. But you know what? I want to read Job 4, verse 11. The mighty lion, king of the beasts, roars mightily. I'm reading from the Message translation. The mighty lion, king of the beasts, roars mightily. But when he's toothless, he's useless. No teeth, no prey. And the cubs wander off to fend for themselves. Therefore, as the church, we need to stand up and protect the cubs and make sure that the cubs don't wander off and fend for themselves in this time, as difficult as it may be. But we still need to stand up and be counted. We still need to look after one another's interest,
Amen.
My brother. Not just my own interest as the person,
yeah.
But look at one another's interest. See to it that my neighbor's breakthrough, I value it as much as that of my own.
Amen.
Amen. Therefore, the church needs to stand together. We need to love one another like never before. We need to spread the love of Christ. We need to reawaken the spiritual
yes.
realm of the church. We need to reawaken our people, not to forget who they are, not to forget whose they are, not to forget the promises of God, to encourage people, to motivate people day in and day out.
Yeah.
Be that go-to guy. Be that guy where people, when they run out of options, go to you, but not to use you as a crutch, but just to get the renewed spirit from you,
yeah.
the renewed word, amen, just to be refreshed as you are both sharing, as the iron sharpens iron,
yes.
hallelujah,
amen.
As deep draws from deep, calls unto deep, amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray that, oh Jesus, you will help us in this time, Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
To not just be a toothless lion, Lord.
Yes.
But, Lord, our roar should be equal, Lord, to our action, Lord. Therefore, Lord, we say we shall not be quiet. We shall not be silent as the church of God, as the body of Christ that reveals who you are, that reveals what you can do
yes.
in the almighty name of Jesus. We shall, Lord, use the little oil that we may have in our houses,
yes.
but we know you are able to multiply it in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
As we are sharing the oil, as we are using the oil, Lord, the anointing will keep on flowing. Therefore, child of God, arise and shine, for your time has come.
Yes.
You may be surrounded by dark darkness, by dense darkness, but I'm telling you,
yes,
the glory of the Lord shines in the darkness. It is the time to be standing and counted as the church. It's the time to shine as the light that we are. It's the time to make a savory taste, to give savory taste to the
yes.
world as the
yes.
salt that we are. In the almighty name of Jesus, make sure when you speak sound. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You of sound words. Hallelujah. You of distasteful words in the almighty name of Jesus. Encourage, hallelujah. We know that, oh Lord, we are called to encourage the weak.
Yes.
We are called to speak the word. The anointing of the Lord is upon us. Therefore, Lord, I pray for renewed strength. I pray for renewed vision. I pray for renewed purpose, Lord,
yes,
in each and every believer's life, oh Lord. In each and every leader, Lord, you give new strength, Lord. We know, Father, this is not the conducive time, but, Lord, in the physical realm is not a conducive time, Lord, but in the, yes, spiritual realm, Lord, this is the time to reveal your glory. This is the time to shine the light. This is the time to trust more. This is the,
yes,
time to reveal who you are. This is the time to reveal whose you, we are. This is the time to reveal on who do we fix our eyes.
Yes.
Amen. Child of God, be encouraged. This is no time to give up. Joshua 1 verse 8 says, meditate. Meditate day and,
yes,
night on the words of,
yes,
God, on,
yes,
this,
yes,
book. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Use it for meditation day and night. Amen. You will be renewed in strength. You will be able to stand in front of any giant.
Yes.
Every place where you put your feet, you will take that place for,
yeah,
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you're meditating on his word. You're meditating on his goodness. You're meditating on his promises. You can't be spending more time on God and be disappointed. Those who wait upon the Lord, they shall get new strength.
Yes.
They shall mount up their wings like that of eagles,
yeah,
because you are expectantly waiting upon the Lord.
Yes.
You know that Jesus will come through for you. You know that Jesus is there for you. While you have not yet received your promise, keep on clapping for those who have received their promises.
Yeah.
Keep on clapping for those, because then you see the work of God around,
yes,
you. You see what God is doing. Hallelujah, child of God. Therefore, value your brother's breakthrough as that of your own. Speak the word in and out of season, because Isaiah 50 verse 4 says, God has given me the tongue of a disciple. The tongue of a disciple is to speak what God says, because you are the disciple of Christ. You are the follower of Christ. You lay down your life for Christ. You don't speak of circumstances. You speak of the truth, Jesus, who,
yes,
never changes. John 8:32 says, you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free.
Amen.
When you are free from fear. You are free from surroundings. You are free from things that don't work for you, because you know that God makes everything to work together for,
yeah,
good for those who love him. If you love God, that is sufficient, because you know what? His grace is sufficient for you. To keep on praying like Paul prayed and said, remove this torment from me.
Mm.
But Jesus said, my grace is sufficient for you.
Mm.
My grace is sufficient for you. Therefore, stand firm on that grace. Rely on that grace. Trust Jesus with your life. Trust Jesus with your life. The Bible says those who try and save their lives, they will lose it. But those who give away their lives to Jesus, they will be saved.
Yes.
Hallelujah. They will be saved. Trust your life with Jesus, child of God. You cannot save yourself. There is nothing that you can do. Give over to Jesus.
Amen.
Trust Jesus with your life. Hallelujah. Give over to him.
Amen.
He is faithful. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He is for you and not against you. Great is he that is in you than he that is out there in the world.
Amen.
In the almighty name of Jesus, be blessed this day. Have a blessed day. Speak the word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's not talk about how big our problems are. In this week, I want to challenge you. Don't speak about how big your problems are. Speak to your problems about how big your God is. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Guys, thank you for watching again.
Oh, yeah.
Really be blessed throughout this week. And stay in prayer.
Yes.
Speak,
yes,
the word of
speak
God.
The
and the word
speak
of God only. Amen.
Speak the word.
And be blessed. And we truly pray for you. Amen.
Hallelujah.